Whether you're a contractor on a commercial building or working on your own home, complying with the International Building Code is important to ensure the safety of the residents or visitors to a newly constructed or renovated building. Handrails and guardrails are a vital part of keeping people safe from injury and potentially fatal falls. These instructions are designed for general contractors, subcontractors, or someone with similar experience. Their purpose is to show how to check handrails and guardrails that have already been installed for code violations. The only tool you will need to check a handrail for code violations is a tape measure that is at least 5 feet or 1.5 meters long. Before we begin, it is important to be familiar with the terms that will be used. First, a dwelling unit refers to the railing being inside of a house, condo, or apartment, not in the stair tower for the apartment or condo building, or anywhere with public access. A handrail is the part of a railing system that is meant to be grabbed to aid in ascending or descending stairways, usually mounted onto a wall or guardrail, but can also be freestanding on posts. Two different handrails are shown in the pictures on the top. Both are mounted on walls. The left is in a house and the right is in a commercial stair tower. Guardrails are railing systems designed to prevent falls from more than 30 inches, commonly built for stairs or ledges, and usually consisting of multiple panels connected by vertical posts. Each panel will typically be less than 60 inches wide and have a top and bottom bar with vertical pickets connecting the two. Two different guardrails are shown in the pictures on the bottom. The left is in a house, and the right is in a commercial stair tower with a handrail mounted on it. A stair point is the outer edge of a single tread on a stairway, where the horizontal step meets the vertical rise on the step beneath it. A strike point is created, where a straight line connecting each stair point passes through the bottom stair point and strikes the ground, as demonstrated in the picture of a tape measure simulating a straight line. Next, we will talk about general handrail rules. These rules are applicable to all handrails in commercial and residential settings. The size and shape of a handrail is often overlooked when handrails are checked for code violations. However, it is vital to ensure that a handrail is neither too big nor too small for a person to grasp. Handrails with a circular cross-section, that is, round like a pipe, must have a minimum diameter of 1.25 inches. And a maximum diameter of 2 inches. This can be measured in any location along the handrail. The picture on the top left is a common size of pipe used in commercial handrails and is 1.75 inches in diameter. If the cross section is not circular, the perimeter of the handrail must be a minimum of 4 inches and a maximum of 6.25 inches. This can be measured by wrapping the tape measure around the handrail. If the handrail exceeds these maximum measurements, it must have a recessed groove for fingers to grasp that begins within 3/4 inches of the top of the handrail. The cross sections shown in the top right picture and both bottom pictures are examples of non-circular handrails that are often used in both commercial buildings and dwelling units. Their perimeters are given below. There must be a minimum space of 1.5 inches between the handrail and the wall or guardrail that it attaches to, in order to provide enough room for a person's hand to grip the railing. As seen in this photograph, the space between the railing and the wall is 1.625 inches, which is 1/8 of an inch larger than the minimum. This section will be about handrails on stairs. Handrails are required where there are 2 or more steps on a stair, or for dwelling units where there are 3 or more steps. For commercial buildings and spaces with public access, handrails must be on both sides of the stair. Measuring from a stair point to the top of a handrail, the minimum height is 34 inches and the maximum is 38 inches. The handrail must end above the strike point. The tape measure can be used to show the location of the strike point to verify the handrail is long enough, as it is demonstrated by the picture below. The handrail must extend 12 inches horizontally past the top stair point. Handrails within private homes and dwelling units must follow the same rules as those in commercial or public locations, with the following exceptions. Handrails are only required on one side of a stair, and a handrail only needs to begin above the top stair point and end at the bottom stair point. Next, we will talk about guardrails that are required on stairs or ledges where it would be possible to fall from 30 inches or more. In both commercial buildings and dwelling units, measuring from a stair point or the floor if on a ledge to the top of the guardrail, the minimum height is 42 inches. However, in a dwelling unit, the guardrail only needs to be 36 inches tall. The two pictures on the top show the heights of the guardrails being measured. The left is on a stair, while the right is on a ledge. Each panel of a guardrail must not have a space large enough for a 4-inch sphere to pass through. Measure each open space, including the spaces between pickets, between the wall and the guardrail, and underneath the lowest bar of a guardrail and either the floor or the stair. In the bottom three pictures, the spaces created by the guardrail are being checked. The left is showing the space between the lowest bar of the guardrail and the stairway, the middle is showing the space between pickets, and the right picture shows the space between the wall and the post of a guardrail. Thank you for watching, and for more information regarding handrail or guardrail codes, consult the International Building Code Book that is available online at codes.iccsafe.org.